Sunshine Band. Gloria Gaynor, Thelma Houston, and Vicky Sue Robinson. Sister Sledge sings We Are Family with Jade. Taylor Day. The Fabulous Stylistics. A tribute to the Eagles with Richard Marx and Randy Meisner. Shy sings You Make Me Feel Brand New. And Rod Stewart. With special appearances by Martin Mull, Sonny Bono, The Bradys. From the Dukes of Hazzard, John Schneider and Tom Wopat. From Laverne and Shirley, Lenny and Squiggy. And Olivia Newton John. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bee Gees. Would you please welcome a major star of any decade, Miss Olivia Newton-John.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm speechless. Good evening. Hello, and thank you. When I see Barry, Morris, and Robin, it takes me back. It takes you back, too. To a really fantastic time for all of us. And the best part of it was, it wasn't so long ago. Well, I love the fact that kids today have made the 70s hip again in music, language, and even fashion. Okay, well, maybe fashion is pushing it a bit, but what goes around comes around. And it seems like only yesterday that Robin Williams was simply a strange-sounding guy from Ork, and Greece was just a country. You do remember, you do. As an environmentalist, I'm all for recycling decades. You know, it saves on the new ones. And the 70s has a lot going for it. Without it, we wouldn't have Elton John, Stevie Wonder, Bruce Springsteen, the Bee Gees, or the Eagles. We would have missed Jaws. All right, that would have been all right. The Godfather, and Annie Hall at the movies, and All in the Family, Mary Tyler Moore, and Roots on TV. It was a time of incredible cultural diversity, and tonight we want to bring some of that back home. All of it, actually. What I liked about the 70s was that you didn't have to have a lot of money to have a good time. You didn't have to go to the right college, drive the right car, spout the right political slogan. It was a time for everybody. Urban cowboys, teeny boppers, metalheads, and all those people who wanted to dance like John Travolta, a few who danced with John Travolta. And even a couple of Aussies thrown in for good measure. So in that spirit, a good time for everyone, we bring you a celebration of the 70s. Yes! Okay, let's get going. Question for you. Now, where were you when you first heard the song Shake Your Booty? You're probably in a club dancing, I know. That's what we did in the 70s. Danced and danced and danced, and we danced some more. And this next group helped to get the whole dance thing going. Based in Miami, they took the rhythm of James Brown and Motown, added some spicy Caribbean salsa to create one of the most distinct and danceable sounds of the era. Ladies and gentlemen, KC and the Sunshine Band.
Thank you.
from Donna Summer. Comedy from Martin Mull. And from the Dukes of Hazzard, John Schneider and Tom Wopat. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome North Ridgeville, Ohio's greatest gift to comedy, Mr. Martin Mull.
Thank you. Hi. I'm Martin Mull. Thank you. Please, please sit down. First of all, I'd just like to say that I am not out here to wallow in the gratuitous applause and possible standing ovation which usually accompanies my mentioning that Fernwood Tonight went on the air in the 70s. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Please, please, sit down. Sit down. I am also not out here as any kind of expert on the 70s either. In fact, I have to confess, I was not really around during the 70s. For those of you who knew me at the time, may I simply jog your memory by saying, cheers. Bear in mind, of course, thanks to the extremely tasteful platform shoes I was wearing in those days, I was 11 inches taller than I am now. Not out of vanity, really, but if you're going to spend $45 on a really good wrinkle-free leisure suit, you know, you want a slight break in the trousers, so. But time has a way of distorting what memory we still have left, and now we look back fondly on those days. Well, kind of fondly. Frankly, it's a little disconcerting to think that we're taking a nostalgic look at a decade in which I was already a full-fledged adult. Just the thought of that makes me feel like Wilfred Brimley poised over a bowl of easy-to-make and even easier-to-chew oatmeal. Wow. Well, actually, I'm not that old. You see, having missed a decade, I saved up some years, you know, because scientists say that when you go way out in space far enough, you're actually younger when you return, and that is certainly where I was during the 70s, so. But I know for many of you kids in your 30s, the 70s were your childhood. Well, unfortunately, it's the only childhood you're going to get. So while you can still remember exactly what happened, I say eat it up, but don't kid yourself. They'll soon be doing specials on the 80s and 90s, and you people will be the target market for all those warm-hearted Depends commercials. A good time so far? That's good. I am too. I can't tell you what an honor it is to be up here with so many of the acts that I really fell in love with during the 70s and still in love with, I guess. And right now, it gives me incredible pleasure to introduce to you someone that I'm sure you're all gonna... I can't place the face. If that stays in the show, what's going to be funny is later on people are going to say, you were on the show, and he goes, yeah, I had a small part. Around 1975, I think it was, I turned on my car radio and heard probably the sultriest pop incantation since Mae West shook her booty. The song was Love to Love You Baby. Do you remember it? Of course you do. Of course. Unless you were hitched up to some machine or were comatose, of course you remember. Well, she's here tonight. She is still most definitely hot stuff. The number one female artist of the 70s and a great voice for any decade. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Donna Summer.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Hazard County, please welcome Luke and Bo Duke, Tom Wopat and John Snyder.
You know, being on a hit television series in the 70s was like kind of like living in a glass house. We couldn't go anywhere without hearing questions like...
Coming up, Rod Stewart and Sister Sledge meets Jay for We Are Family. Gentlemen, please welcome Jay.
Thank you.
Hi. We loved a lot of music of the 70s. It had a joyous spirit that made everybody feel good.
One of our favorite groups came out of Philadelphia and had one of the real anthems of the time.
It became so popular in 1979 that it became the official theme song of the Pittsburgh Pirates and helped lead them to a World Series win. Yay! Singing We Are Family, please welcome Sister Sledge!
Family. Get up, everybody, and sing.
It was the family sitcom of the 70s, and if you ask the kids of the 90s, it's still the best. The Bradys. See? Well, you know, they've done it all. They've done network syndication, a variety show, a very Brady Christmas, and the list just goes on and on and on. So we wondered, in the days of Phil and Sally, Montel and Oprah, how the Bradys would come back today. So here it is, the first all-Brady cable channel. All day, every day. Wall-to-wall Bradys. Let's tune in. It's time for Brady Talk.
So very much. Hello, everybody. Now, if you have just joined us,
we're the Bradys.
I'm Carol.
I'm Greg.
I'm Peter.
I'm Bobby.
And I'm Cindy.
Ever do is talk about ourselves. Now, let me see, where were we? Yes, Greg. Now, you know that rumor has been running rampant for years. Now, I really would like you to tell me, did you or did you not date me, your mom?
Let's talk about Johnny Bravo now. I really love being Johnny Bravo. I really fit that suit.
Yes, you did.
Okay, well, let's take our first question.
Okay, let me. Hi. Hi. Hi, how are you?
Good.
Woo. Hi. So, you have a question for one of the Bradys?
Yeah, I have a question. It's for any of the Bradys. I knew about you and Greg, but I heard that one of you was messing around with the maid, Alice.
Hey, that is outrageous.
Yes. I did once. It was an accident.
And Tiger howled all night.
Oh, Greg, now be kind. Oh, caller, you're on.
I'd like to know, what about Bobby and Cindy?
No, never. Not in a million years.
Absolutely, all the time. I love those curls.
You're lying.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
You
am
say
not.
You're lying, I'll bop you.
Hey, you two kids, stop that. Break it up. Whoa. Well, you sure hit a nerve, caller. You know, we can do a show on that.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
What about you, Mom? Who are you really into?
You mean, besides you?
What about Sam the Butcher? He was always bringing meat over to the house. We sure had to eat a lot of pork chops and applesauce.
And Joe Namath, how did he get on the show?
And whatever happened to your first husband?
Who cares? Let's talk about Marcia. I always thought that she was groovy.
Me too.
Me three.
Enough! Stop it. I don't like this.
Temper, Cindy.
Oh, get your hands off me.
Ow, Mom!
Oh, Cindy, Bobby, now stop that. Remember? You're the Bradys. I think we have time for just one more question. Yes.
Hi. Does anyone remember the words to Sunshine Day?
Sure.
can't stay inside all day. I gotta get out, give me some of those rays.
Everybody's happy.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, please welcome Miss Donna Summer.
Last dance, last chance for love. Yes, it's my last chance for romance tonight. I need you by me, beside me, to guide me, to hold and scold me, 'cause when I'm mad, I'm so, so bad.
You wanna dance?
So
a dime a dance? How about just half a chance tonight? Oh, please, mister, can't you see? This is my last chance for romance. That's right.